Hello and welcome. Hello and welcome to the 2016 Directing Change Program and Film Contest Statewide Awards Ceremony. Thank you for joining us. My name is Stan Collins, and I will be your guide this evening on a wonderful exploration of stories told through film, from the minds and voices of some of these amazing youth. Now, today we have gathered to recognize the power of one voice, the potential that one has to impact the lives of others, the lives of many. And the power of one is strongest when we stand together. One voice demanding that we as a society finally understand mental health and save more lives from suicide. But to do this, we need to be united. For the pursuit of mental health equality and suicide prevention requires constant vigilance. Now, there is a role for each of us to play in this most important script, the stories of our lives and the lives of those we love. There is a hero in each of us, one with the power to stand up and stand with those who need us, one with the strength to know when we ourselves need help and support. And today, you will meet many of my heroes, the young filmmakers who we come here to recognize. As President Clinton once said, and for the youngsters in the crowd, I need to clarify that I'm referring to someone way back in the 1900s. Mental illness. That went over better than I thought. Mental illness is nothing to be ashamed of, but stigma and bias shame us all. Together, we will replace stigma with acceptance, ignorance with understanding, fear with a new hope for the future. And you young filmmakers, you are part of that future. Today, we come here to honor you, you who decided to stand and direct change. If all the youth in the audience who submitted a film, those in front and those throughout the house, would please stand so we can give them one huge round of applause. These youth have taken part in one of this generation's most vital social movements, the movement for mental health. Now, it's actually very appropriate that we come together here on this day, as May is recognized throughout our country as Mental Health Awareness Month. Directing Change is part of this, and is part of Each Mind Matters, California's mental health movement. Each Mind Matters' goal is to amplify the voices around the state speaking up about mental health and taking action this month and throughout the year. We symbolize our solidarity by the simple act of displaying a green ribbon. The vibrant color is the symbol of Each Mind Matters and the symbol of this movement. As I mentioned, our young filmmakers are now part of that movement. And each of you here who showed up today are now part of that movement. And Each Mind Matters is part of statewide efforts to prevent suicide, reduce stigma and discrimination as it relates to mental illness, and to promote the mental health and wellness of students. These initiatives are funded by counties through the Mental Health Services Act, Prop 63, and are administered by the California Mental Health Services Authority, also known as CalMESA, an organization of county governments working to improve mental health outcomes for individuals, families, and communities. I want to send a heartfelt thank you to CalMESA and the county mental health directors for believing in directing change, for believing in our youth. And thank you as well to our sponsors and partners who have contributed by donating programs, their time, or with financial support. I want to send a special thank you to the Dallas Pugh Foundation. The Dallas Pugh Foundation was created by the Pugh family to honor the memory of their son and brother Dallas after his death by suicide 20 years ago today. The Dallas Pugh Foundation works to prevent youth suicide through a variety of upstream approaches. Their motto, "Go Big, Give Back," encourages all of us to take care of those around us and to know ourselves when to reach out for help. So thank you to the Dallas Pugh Foundation for their support and for joining us, especially today. I'd also like to thank the students from Canyon High School's film class down in Orange County for being here tonight to document the event. If we could give them one round of applause. And finally, one final shout out to University High School and Daniel Pearl High School for joining us today. I appreciate the leadership at your schools believing in this program and believing in the value of you being here today. But there is nothing for free in this world, and I want to let you know I expect to see some submissions in this contest next year from you guys, so I'm challenging you right now. Now, today will be filled with a lot of celebration, but it will also be filled with a lot of emotion, because these issues of mental health and suicide prevention are near and dear to many of our hearts. And I want to let you know that if at any time tonight emotions rise to the surface, that's okay. You're going to see some from me probably. But if you need support, you need to step out for a moment. We have some crisis counselors who will be at the resource tables out in the lobby through support from the LA Department of Mental Health. Please step out. Feel free to talk with them and gather some resources. So the Directing Change Program and Film Contest encourages young people to learn about suicide prevention, learn about mental health, and how to support a friend in an innovative way through the creation of film, researching these topics, applying knowledge to the making of the film, and thinking deeply about impacting the opinions of others requires a level of involvement that has lasting impact. It is our hope that the experience of making or watching these films will inspire you to become agents of change, standing up for and reaching out to other young people who are experiencing tough times, that they will be aware of the warning signs for suicide, that they will reach out to a trusted adult if they're concerned about a friend. And as a result, young people will get the help that they need. They will find acceptance and that they won't have to face mental illness alone. I want to share with you some words of our filmmakers that were sent to us this year. I think the biggest way making the film impacted my team is the conversations that it opened up. Through the backdrop of filmmaking, the three of us had some serious talks about the subject of suicide, its effects on our generation, and the effects on each of us personally. Overall, I think that this is the largest benefit of the program. It starts conversations. Another filmmaker wrote, "This contest was very personal to me because I suffer from depression and anxiety, and even suicidal tendencies. I've been to the hospital twice for attempted suicide, and it's a serious issue that needs to be talked about more. This contest allowed me to express how mental illness feels and describe it correctly in my video. I never want anyone to suffer what I suffered through alone, so this video and contest allowed me to lend at least a little help to those in need." Now, the impact of this program reaches far beyond the students to the entire school community. For example, students at Whitney High School challenged and convinced their school to allow them to host a Mental Health Awareness Week on their campus. During this week, each segment of the school's bulletin featured a film from Directing Change as they spoke to their students about mental health and suicide prevention. And we have been absolutely humbled by the response to this program. This year, a total of 451 films were received from 31 counties throughout California. These films represent over 1,000 students at over 90 different high schools and 35 colleges and community organizations. Film entries to Directing Change were judged by over 200 volunteer experts in mental health and suicide prevention, members of the media and professionals in writing and filmmaking. And now I'd like to take a moment and recognize some of our judges and some of our biggest supporters who have come here to join us today. Mr. Michael Gilveri. There you are, Michael. Thank you. Miss Meredith O'Connor. Miss Devin McNair. Miss Pixie Monroe. Miss Gren Wells. Mr. Eric Close. Mr. Lakeith Stanfield. Get him, Lakeith. Mr. Gavin McIntosh. Mr. Brett Davern. Miss Naomi Grossman. And Mr. Raphael Sparge. And there are a lot of other people who have contributed to this program, so I'm sorry we simply don't have time to acknowledge everyone, but thank you to all of you for your support and your time here to be here today. Please. Now it is my great honor to introduce our first speaker this afternoon. Dr. Robin Kay is the acting director for the Los Angeles County Department of Mental Health. She has dedicated her life to the fundamental belief that all people have value, that strong mental health is achievable for all, and that we all have the right to quality care. She's done this by promoting hope, wellness, and recovery for the residents of Los Angeles County. And ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Ms. Dr. Robin Kay.
Well, good afternoon to all of you, and welcome to Los Angeles. It's a delight to be here with you today. You know, we all know that it's important, critical in fact, that we do two things to ensure that people with mental illness have access to the care that they need and deserve. And that journey toward mental health wellness begins with increasing awareness and decreasing stigma, which is what we're here to celebrate today. The Los Angeles County Department of Mental Health is the largest public mental health system in the country, if not the world. And still, we are challenged every day to ensure that we increase that awareness and decrease stigma in our community so that people feel comfortable about receiving mental health care. It is true that the best ways to accomplish that task are to tell our stories. The most effective way to ensure that people understand the journey toward mental health is through telling our own stories, often through films or through written material. 63 years ago, one young person, Anne Frank's diary was published. And that diary, Anne Frank, gave a window into the experience of a young adult in war-torn Europe. It changed the attitudes that people had toward the experience of young adults suffering through years of devastation. And of course, those of you who have made films today, you're here to do something similar, to change the attitudes that people have in our community toward mental health, enabling thousands to get help from county departments of mental health and our service providers. You know, Anne Frank, 63 years ago, wrote these words, "Thank goodness that no one need ever wait a single moment before beginning to improve the world." And I could use those same words to each and every one of the filmmakers we're here to celebrate today. Thank goodness that none of you have wasted a single moment before beginning to improve our world. We are so grateful to you, and I'm happy to introduce the first group of films on mental health matters. Thank you so much for being here today, and welcome to Los Angeles.
Thank you, Dr. Kay. Where were we? All right, they'll figure that out. Don't worry about it. All right. The first category of awards this evening is this is the High School Mental Health Matters category. Research shows that half of all mental illnesses start by age 14 and three quarters start by age 24. But an average of 6 to 8 years pass after the symptoms of mental illness begin before young people get help. But I ask, what is mental health? Mental health, mental fitness, mental wellness, it's something that impacts each and every one of us. And yet we don't talk about it as much as we should. It impacts everyone, not just those of us living with a mental illness. See, I believe that mental health is at the essence of who we are. I believe that how we discuss mental health, whether we seek help, how we support each other is at the core of our values as a society. Sometimes the most important first step, though, is to simply end the silence. To define our mental health, though, we must start by asking some tough questions. How am I feeling, not just how am I doing? How am I dealing with the stresses in life? Am I fulfilling the obligations that I have to those that I love? And just as the definition of mental health varies by person, so does the path to mental wellness. To achieve mental wellness, we each take that unique path with its own obstacles, various viewpoints and vistas, and small victories. Now, we will each meet different people along the way, some that will help us and others that we will assist. And the following films offer perspective on some of these important questions. These films help others to know how to support others they love, how to seek help themselves, and helping to change the conversation one by one in our society about mental health. And ladies and gentlemen, we will now hear the voices of these young filmmakers, and it is my pleasure to introduce the high school submissions to the Mental Health Matters category. Thank you.
This is me, and I struggle with mental health challenges. I started to feel isolated and alone, like none of my friends understood me or what I was feeling. One day, I reached out and shared my story with a friend. She understood more than I thought and even wanted to help. I realized that each time I shared my story, I felt a little better. This is me, these are my moments, and this is my life beyond my mental health challenge. It's important to remember that social media doesn't show every aspect of someone's life. Don't forget to log out and have a real conversation with those you love. To join the conversation, visit eachmindmatters.org.
So what is that, like 2070?
It's really not that big of a deal.
Okay. Give me. How many fingers am I holding up?
We call this naivete. I don't go blind without my glasses, and for the sake of this public service announcement, I'm just going to flat out tell you that I represent somebody with a mental health issue. And he represents, thank you, he represents the portion of society that is unaware of societal stigmas. See, with someone perpetuating the notion that people with a mental health issue are completely debilitated and unable to function around normal people, that prevents the 1 in 5 teens who do deal with a mental health issue from seeking help. We shouldn't be treated any differently. Sometimes we just need a little help.
Looks like a metaphor.
Everything started shifting into black and white. It seemed like life went in slow motion. I started to drift away from the people I cared about. I realized something wasn't right, so I talked to a friend about it. She told me to visit reachout.com. From there, I learned that there were other people carrying the same weight as me. I got help, and so can you. If you or a friend are experiencing a mental health challenge, talk about it. It's never too late to get help.
Dear Amanda.
Dear Amanda.
Dear Amanda.
Dear Amanda. When you're drowning, blurry-eyed and numb, when you feel like you're fighting a losing battle,
alone, like others will look the other way.
I want you to know that we will run to catch you, and we will hold on to your hand
and not let go.
Because I know you're there, struggling to speak.
Because I know you can climb even higher, no matter how many times you've lost your grip.
Even with your wounds,
your scars,
your scratches,
your burns and bruises,
inside and out.
I care, and I will be there.
Sincerely, John.
Jennifer.
Michelle.
Rose.
Shiv.
Lucille.
Amanda.
It comes and goes. Some days I feel fine, others not so much. There are days when I could barely get out of bed. I felt overpowered, weighed down. I felt alone. It was like my mind was locked in a dark room and I wasn't able to turn on the light. Sometimes things are fine. I feel free, even though I know it won't last. I was sure they wouldn't understand, but living every day like you're drowning is no way to live. So I talked about it. I told them. I reached out. It didn't change all at once. I still felt lost, dazed, and confused, but soon I realized I wasn't alone. We are not alone. We are not defined by the world around us or the challenges we face. We are more than that. We are full of journeys and stories and futures, and we will overcome.
If you or someone you know is experiencing an emotional crisis, please reach out or visit EachMindMatters.org.
On stage, the lights shine bright. You deliver your lines, conveying every emotion, every subtle feeling. Months of practice have let you capture your character completely. But out here, at school, you still fall back on the same old script, delivering the same old lines. Only these ones, you've been practicing for years. Phrases like, "I'm fine," and "everything is okay." But here's the deal. You don't have to hide behind a script. This is your life. Not a performance. Out here, you are the star of the show. The people who care about you want to see the real you, not the person you're pretending to be. Start a conversation, because if you want to talk, they will listen. Your story is better than any script could ever be. Please, visit EachMindMatters.org for more information.
I read somewhere that first impressions are made in the first 7 seconds of meeting someone. In those first 7 seconds, people already have a mental image of how they perceive you, who you are, and what your life is like. Although first impressions are important, those 7 seconds can't tell the full story, because the full story is more complex than 7 seconds. Those 7 seconds can't tell you that 2 years ago I was diagnosed with depression. People don't talk about depression or mental illness, so I thought I couldn't either. I was afraid of what people would think, but talking openly about it was the first step in getting the support that I needed. My mental illness is a part of me and a part of my life, but it doesn't define my character. Anyone can be affected by a mental illness, but luckily, anyone can help. To join the mental health movement and help end the stigma on mental illness, visit eachmindmatters.org, because we can only beat the things we fight alone if we stand together.
Absolutely amazing. Now, courage comes in many forms. Courage can be speaking about what others will not. It can be subtle. Courage is simply just sharing stories when others need to hear it. And as you just saw, films can be courageous. But rarely do films take a look at severe mental illness in a positive light. But the film, The Road Within, focuses on young people living with severe mental illness as part of their full life experience. The film is brave in that it demonstrates the frustrations and the trauma experienced by these individuals living with mental illness and how it complicates their life, but also the strengths gained from these same experiences. The main character in the film, Vincent, who lives with severe Tourette syndrome and is learning to truly embrace life with support of his friends and his helpers. One of the most touching moments comes early in the film when the psychologist, Dr. Mia Rose, asks Vincent about what his dreams and goals are in his life. This scene is a beautiful portrayal of how important that helpers are in recovery and how we all need to support those living with mental illness. And just because they face challenges, they should not be prevented from striving for their goals. And it is with great pleasure and honor that I present the award for Outstanding Film About Mental Illness and Young People to Gren Wells, director and writer of the film, The Road Within. Please welcome.
Thank you all so much for this incredible honor. Coming from an organization such as Each Mind Matters and Directing Change, knowing that you guys are putting the voice or giving children a voice to talk about this and to destigmatize it is amazing. As someone who, you know, because you guys are out in high school, AKA a war zone of bullying and meanness. I mean, you guys can be really mean. When I was 15, a horse stepped on my face, broke my nose and my cheekbone. I had scars everywhere. And trust me, no one wants to be friends with a girl who has a hoof print in her face. So I had to make a decision. And I decided, like, I better have a sense of humor about things. And that sense of humor got me through a lot. Many of the trying times that I went on to have for a long time after that. It's also made me a lot of money. So kids, when your parents, you know, when you can tell them that being a wise ass does pay. So, but it was important to make this movie just because my mom suffered from depression growing up, and I remember being embarrassed of her because I didn't want anyone to know. And so looking back, if anyone, you know, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. We all have issues. We all have things about ourselves that we don't like or we're embarrassed about. So what makes us any different than them? Nothing. We're all the same. We all need help at various points in our lives. So making this film was huge to help destigmatize mental health issues. And so I have to thank, first and foremost, my producers, two of which are here today, Michael Helfand and Brent Emery. They're right over there. Because
they paid for it, and, you know, films are expensive. But, you know, it was something that I did feel was essential. We did a tremendous amount of research into each of the disorders, Tourette's, anorexia, and OCD, because we wanted the portrayals to be authentic. I didn't want them to be the butt of a joke, which isn't to say that you can't laugh at yourself, because like I said, we are all ridiculous. And that I felt like that was the first step in healing, was Vincent learning that when he says, and I'm not going to repeat them here, if you guys have seen the film, there's a lot of curse words, but when he says some of his tics, he realizes it is funny, it is okay to laugh at yourself. And then that is the first step in his healing. So I encourage you all, it's on Netflix now, you guys can watch it if you haven't seen it, and just continue to make films, because the ones that I saw, it was impossible to judge. I want to give each and every one of you an award, because you truly are at that forefront of the fight to help destigmatize mental health. So thank you so much.
And with that, thank you, Ms. Wells. And she will join me in presenting the awards for the statewide high school Mental Health Matters category. And our first prize of the evening, third prize in the Mental Health Matters high school category, goes to Naivete Canyon High School in Orange County, Nick Jackson, Susie Anderson, Ethan Burke, and Cassie Keith, advisor Alex Graham.
Thank you, everyone. This is our school, our Canyon High School in Anaheim. This is our school's third year participating in this event. And, you know, the first year it was, if anybody was at the event last night, Alex Graham said, hey, maybe we can win some money. We didn't really know the value of it. And this year, you know, it was a given that we were going to participate in this because we saw the impact it had on us in the past 2 years. And it's an honor to be up here tonight. And I'd just like to thank everybody again for this opportunity.
Hello. First of all, I want to congratulate everyone who made any film that we saw up here. They were amazing. I was sitting in my seat and I was getting emotional because they're just so beautiful. As someone living with mental illness, this program is so special to me because, you know, back in the day when I was diagnosed and everything, there was no conversation. In schools, at home, there was nothing. So it was like I felt really alone. But through this, it was really, really awesome because it sparked up conversations and I was able to relate to my close friends about it and we were talking about it and it just generated a lot of awesome stuff. So thank you so much.
Second prize for the Mental Health Matters High School category goes to Off the Script, Butt County, Pleasant Valley High School, Ryan Martin and Caden White, advisor Michael Peck.
Thank you.
So, this is a surprise, but I was really inspired by this whole thing, and the whole concept for me was our video. It blew me away just how much it affected me, because I've always told people how I felt when they ask me how I'm doing, and everyone looked at me like I'm weird, like they wanted to hear, good, I would walk off. So it was just really amazing to be able to bring a message to people and to be part of this event. Thank you.
Hi. Sorry. For me, really, this is just such an awesome opportunity. I'm really just grateful for two things. First of all, to Stan here and everyone who's participating, and the judges and teachers and parents, first off, who made this possible, our teacher, Mr. Peck. But second of all, more importantly, I'm really grateful for the opportunity to make a video that could possibly make an impact in someone's life. And because I know, at least for me and Caden, it opened our eyes to how important it is to just be there for people and just value them as an individual, just be ready to talk. Thank you.
You want me to read the winner? Yeah. All right. First prize for the Mental Health Matters High School category goes to The Journey. Marin County, Redwood High School, Benedict Conrad, Thomas Hayden Smeltzer, Asha Cummings, and Dominique Cruz, advisor name Peter Parrish.
Say thank you for this, and thank you so much for the opportunity to be able to make these films and get the message out there, because it's really important to us. Thank you so much to our teacher Peter Parrish, because he's just been a great influence and helping us, challenging us every day. And we also wanted to give a shout out to all our friends who have been dealing with mental illnesses and just trying to get through every day, because they're struggling a lot. Some of them, some of them are doing great, and we know as a group that it's a journey to get through this, and it's a process, and we just want them to know that we're there for them kind of every step of the way, and we're always there to be able to talk to them and just help them whenever they need it. And so that's kind of why we wanted to make this movie about a journey, because we know it's not just a easy fix, it's a real process. So thank you.
Thank you. Sorry, one second, everyone. Grant and I will meet you in just a second to take a picture. All right. Research shows that 60 to 80% of young people tell a friend that they're thinking about suicide. But less than 25% of those friends go on to seek help for that person. Every one of us has the power to save a life if we know the signs, if we find the words, and if we reach out. With suicide prevention, it's important to understand that certain presentations of the subject matter may influence a vulnerable person towards suicide behavior or towards seeking help. These filmmakers address this delicate subject with respect, beautifully sharing the message that suicide can be prevented. In their films, they encourage you to reach out for help, to not keep a secret, and to educate others on the role they play. And we will now view the statewide nominees for the high school suicide prevention category.
One of the major concerns that is known worldwide is suicide. It's not enough to just give figures on the many folks who chose to take their lives. More has to be done to help those in need. Listen to someone who is openly telling you that they are feeling suicidal. Do not shut them down and say, "It's just a phase." It is better to take precautions of the warning. After someone expresses the thoughts of suicide, reassure them that they can come back and talk to you whenever they need to. To really show that you are concerned about them, check in once in a while after the conversation by saying, "I wanted to check in and see how you've been feeling." It is important that your voice and manners are expressed properly and seriously. It is better to take precautions of the warning than wait until it is too late. If you or someone you know is experiencing an emotional stress or thinking about suicide, and you are unsure how to deal with a situation, call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline immediately.
That's my friend Ben, and this is our story. Ever since we were little kids, we've always been best friends. He was the happiest kid I knew. Then little by little, everything began to change. It seemed as if time began to just pass him by. He felt lost and alone. He would seclude himself from others, pushing away his friends and family. All the signs led to it. I knew he was suicidal. I reached out and found suicideispreventable.org. I confronted Ben about the situation and told him that help is available. It took some time, and it definitely wasn't easy, but it was well worth it to know I haven't lost my friend. Suicide is preventable. Know the signs and reach out.
This is it. She's decided to take her own life. She's lost. Alone. Isolated. Too broken inside to ask for help. She remembers how happy she was in the past, but all of that is gone. But it must not end this way. They matter. You matter. You can save someone. Know the warning signs of suicide. And most importantly, reach out. Give them the help they need.
Hello?
This is the National Suicide Prevention Hotline.
You haven't been like yourself lately.
Yeah, what's up? All the things we used to do. You don't seem to enjoy them anymore.
It's like you've been isolating yourself and you look depressed all the time. Is this something we can talk about?
There's nothing to talk about. Please. I'd like to be left alone. Hold on. Please, just leave me alone, you two.
We can't just let him go, can we?
We need to contact a counselor or something. Get him the help he needs. It is okay to betray a friend's trust if it will save their life. If you know someone who is thinking about attempting suicide, you can do something to prevent them. Help them cope with their pain and show them that they are not alone, that taking their life is not an option. Suicide is preventable. All it takes is a single person, a single action. You can be that person. You can reach out. You can make a difference. If you or someone you know is contemplating suicide, call the National Suicide Hotline at 1-800-273-TALK. For more information, go to www.suicideispreventable.com.
It started so harmless. I just thought that Tyler was having some longer sleepless nights. Then he started to isolate himself from me. I wasn't sure if I did anything to make him mad, but things were changing. Once he started drinking, it was time to do something about it. Ever since I went up to talk to Tyler, I've never been closer to him. If you see any strange signs of anxiety or isolation, don't be afraid to speak out. Know the signs.
One more round of applause for our filmmakers. It is now my great pleasure to introduce to you a man that I have come to deeply respect for his talent, but more importantly for his passion of making art that matters. You already know he's an amazing actor, but Lakeith Stanfield is a beautiful vocalist and musician, all around an artist who isn't afraid to go to the depths with you and bare his soul. I was deeply touched by the lyrics in one of his songs where he states, "I don't trust in what I see anymore. I won't believe in dreams and reaching peaks with ankles anchored to the sea floor." This line touched me about the struggles we all face and how vital hope is to recovery. Lakeith is here tonight to accept the award for outstanding film about suicide prevention on behalf of the film in which he stars, Short Term 12. The film Short Term 12 respectfully explores many issues that are too often unspoken. Although at the surface the film could be naively summarized as just a story about troubled youth, the film goes much further to explore the issues of mental health, abuse, self-harm, and suicide in a way that feels real and identifies with the viewer regardless of their background. In the film, Lakeith Stanfield delivers a raw performance as Marcus, a teenager faced with the imminent threat of outaging the foster care system, a role for which he earned an Independent Spirit Award nomination. Through the film, we come to know Marcus and his strength, his frailty from trauma, and his enormous heart. A focal point in the film is when Marcus makes a suicide attempt. Now, at first glance, this event may appear as just a side plot in the film. But upon further reflection, the warning signs of his attempt are spread across the script, leading to this moment demonstrating to us, the viewer, how vital it is to know the signs, to find the words, and to reach out. The film beautifully shows the love that we can all share for each other and the many troubles in life that we all face.
And ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce Lakeith Stanfield and award him for Short Term 12 with the award for Outstanding Film About Suicide Prevention.
He's trying to get away from the spotlight. Thank you. Yeah, that was beautifully said. Thank you very much. It's great to be here. What's up, young people? Oh man, this is awesome. I'm glad to see people taking the reins and creating their own stuff. Long before I was an actor, I would just like go out in the middle of the desert with a camera and just start filming myself, and people thought I was crazy, but and I am. But this is a special category for me, because the lyrics he was quoting are based off of my brother, who was dealing with suicide on and off and attempted to end his own life. And I just remember being on the side of him during the time he was in the hospital. He drank antifreeze and kept coming in and out of consciousness. And I just remember him at the you know, one of the times when he went out and he came back up, he said, "I don't want to die." And it's a very complex human phenomena, intelligence, and it can be a beautiful thing for many different reasons, but it also can be something that can become a crack den if we spend too much time in our minds and contemplating things. And I think it always matters to have someone to support you to the end. There came a point through all of his back and forth where I came to the decision that if you wanted to end your life, that's okay. No one should make you stay here. But when I found out that he really wanted to live, then I had to reassess myself and like, wow, damn, this is a very complex thing and there's no right or wrong way to deal with it. But one thing that we always got to do is just support each other and be here for each other. So I appreciate having a discussion, and I appreciate all of you guys' bravery and speaking your piece about this. So thank you.
With that, third prize in the high school suicide prevention category goes to Leap of Faith, Riverside County, Murrieta Valley High School, Benjamin Finney and Ella Harrison.
First off, I'd like to say it's an honor, and I'd like to thank Stan and Shanti, all the judges, and especially Miss Harrison. Now, I would like to dedicate this video in loving memory of Kaylee Finney. Kaylee is a beloved family member of mine who, this past summer, committed suicide. It was tragic and truly the hardest thing that any and all of our family has gone through. But this organization helps me feel like I can make a difference and helps me feel like I can make a change to prevent that from happening to others, to help, to find the light. And that's what Kaylee was. That's what Kaylee would do. She would find the best of the worst situations, find the light from the darkness. And that's what motivated me to make this video, to be the light and to share that light with everyone in hopes that I don't care whether one person sees it, or thousands of people see it. If it can change a mind, possibly even save a life, that's all that matters. And it's why we're doing it. Thank you. I'm proud to be here. I'd like to thank teacher Ella Harrison and this guy for making it all happen. And it was a great video, great experience. We had to maneuver around some security to get that cliff jump scene, but it was all worth it. I just want to thank this program for allowing me to use my hobby for to raise awareness for a good cause. First of all, I'd like to dedicate this video, you know, not to only, you know, the problems that we described in the video, but to anybody who has lost somebody in general, you know, I don't know if anybody have heard of one of my friends named Gage Seal. He was somebody who, you know, was murdered a while ago, and I now know how it feels to lose somebody, and, you know, for somebody to commit suicide, that can affect a lot of different people in a lot of different ways. So, you know, I just want to, you know, thank you for giving me this opportunity to help make a difference, and you know, thank you for having me.
Second place in the high school suicide prevention category goes to Hand of Hope.
So to start off, we'd like to thank our advisor, Ms. Nina LaRosa, and our principal, Mr. Zach Larson, who introduced us to this wonderful competition and took time out of his busy schedule to be with us here today. We'd also like to thank Shanti, Stan, and the Directing Change team for making this such a wonderful and memorable experience.
So in several schools around the Bay Area, and especially at our school, there seems to be this stigma that surrounds mental illness, that the people who are seeking for help and looking for help from others are viewed as weak, that they can't seem to deal with the pressure that everyone else seems to so perfectly manage.
So our school especially focuses so much on academics that we oftentimes lose touch with what really matters, which is our mental health. And we know personally a few people who have struggled with this and have struggled with the expectations set by others and set by themselves.
So when we were making this video, we were really thinking about those who are silently struggling with depression and are too afraid or just reluctant to speak up and ask for help. And being friends and family of people who are silently struggling and we don't even know that they're struggling or have suicidal thoughts, we think it's really important to emphasize that we should reach out to them and that we can't, all of us can give them the emotional support and the resources and information that they need. And I think Directing Change has really exposed us to the things that we can do to help. So thank you.
Sure, we could do it simultaneously. Which one? This one. And the statewide winner in the high school suicide prevention category is the Guides of Life.
Sacramento County Franklin High School, Ryan Santiago, advisor Brian Bradford.
Ready to come up here in case I did win, but like coming up here, I'm all like, I can really feel my heart beating and I'm trembling. So first of all, I just want to congratulate everyone for amazing videos. You all did a really amazing job, and I'm glad that there are so many people out there that want to get the message out, that want to raise awareness for these problems. Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm sorry. Really hard in this film, like half a year, just doing all this stuff, storyboarding, everything. You saw it was like the only animation in the entire, I'm sorry, it's shaking. I worked really hard on it, and I'm glad that all the hard work paid off, and I'm glad that, you know, my hard work can possibly help at least one person, if not one, then many, if not many, then at least one. And it's been a great experience, and I'm really glad that I was able to raise awareness about suicide, awareness about how to prevent suicide. I'm sorry, I've been up here for a really long time, probably longer than everyone else. I'd like to make a special dedication to one of my friends back in Elk Grove, where I live. Her name is Pauline. She was someone that, back in my sophomore year, I was feeling depressed. I had all these thoughts. I was actually thinking about attempting suicide, and she was one of the only people that actually took me seriously when I said it, and she was able to, you know, I kind of consider her as like having contributed to me being here today, having this film be something that you could all see. And I'm glad. I'd like to thank her, and I'd thank all of you. I'm just glad that I could help with this amazing cause.
I want to say thank you. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, thank you for being here.
All right. Ryan, you just won the award for best speech of the night. It was touching. It was, because tonight we're here to talk about the power of one. We're going to talk about another one who's made a huge impact. Meredith O'Connor is a teen pop star and anti-bullying icon. Her music is loved by millions, and her songs, including Just the Thing and Stronger, a duet with Disney's Garrett Clayton, are about embracing who you are. She has participated as a statewide judge for the past 2 years with Directing Change, and Meredith O'Connor has partnered with Directing Change to encourage teens to be inclusive, tolerant of one another's differences, and support mental health by participating in this program. I had the pleasure of speaking alongside Meredith
At a number of high schools in California, we discussed the topics of mental health, suicide prevention, and bullying awareness. I witnessed firsthand her connections to the students and the impact of how her story of strength and resiliency resonated with them. And it's now my pleasure to thank and award Meredith O'Connor with the Directing Change recognition for 2016 MVP, Program Supporter, and Student Mentor. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Meredith O'Connor.
Thank you so much. I get so emotional at these things because, and I had the pleasure of speaking with Stan at school. It's one of my favorite things to do because I've seen how much it impacts so many people in the world. I've been lucky enough to travel around the world touring and doing lots of concerts and lots of meet and greets, and I can honestly say that despite all that, right now I'm in a room with the most brilliant people and the most smart people that I've ever met in my life. And the reason is because not only brilliant and smart and inspirational, but strong. Some of the strongest people I'll ever know are here because you guys are going through, and I know because I went through it, some of the hardest things ever. And it's not always seen as that because it's not visible. But as someone who went through severe, severe anxiety, like really crippling anxiety, I can tell you that middle school was the hardest time of my life. And I'm 19 years old now, and I used to think I was the only one who went through it, which is so crazy because I literally get thousands and thousands of messages from people saying they feel alone. And as an entertainer, as we all are, you know, we all have a platform, you're all making films, and it's, as somebody in the industry, it is our responsibility to use our voice for good, and it's our responsibility to use our experiences to help other people, and that's what you guys have done today. And you guys have made films that you guys will do things that will change people's lives, and these films have the power to change lives, and you all have that ability. So thank you so much for using your power for good. And thank you, Directing Change in Each Mind Matters, and Stan, for giving, you know, for doing such amazing things and saving lives and just being one of the most amazing programs I've ever seen, ever. So thank you so much. Thank you.
And now we actually have the pleasure of hearing Meredith perform for us.
Yes. This song, Just the Thing, is actually part of what I want to teach my fans and anyone who listens to my music, especially when I, at meet and greets, when people say they're being bullied for being weird or being tall. That was something I always got made fun of. It's something that I think is, I learned over the years that it's something that makes you special. And the things that make you weird and different and strange, and the things that you may have hated in middle school or even are insecure about now, are the things that will make you successful. So if I could tell anything to all of you, just please don't change what makes you special and brilliant. That's what the song Just the Thing is about. So thank you. Touch and think too much off hand. I'm in the clouds and I'll probably never land. I don't fit in with the in crowd, but I fit with you. And I don't fit in, but I like out, 'cause you're a little weird too. And that's just the thing I like about you. Thing I like about you. I once had a world of supposed friends, but everyone knows that fair weather always ends, and those who stay to better days rarely come along our way. They make me smile, and I just gotta say, I don't fit in with the in crowd.
don't fit in, but I like out, cause you're a little weird too, and that's just the thing I like about you. Without you I can hardly see the happiness around me. The company you made, I wouldn't trade it for $1 million. It's true, you light a spark. Without you I'm in the dark, and I'll never be able to find the light again. When you're strange, it's hard to find someone to stay till the end. I don't fit in with the in crowd, but I but I like out, cause you're a little weird too. Yeah, you always make me smile. Cause I've been down for a while, and I'll show you every day that my love won't go away. And you lift me off the ground whenever you're around. You know you're strange, but I'm the same way too. And that's just the thing I like about you. Just the thing I like about you. Thank you so much, guys. And thank you, Stan.
The Directing Change program accepted entries from youth and young adults between the ages of 16 to 25 in a separate category from the high school students. As you heard earlier, many people in this age group will deal with mental illness and mental health challenges during these years. And it's vital that we and their peers hear messages from one another about the importance of mental health, that it's okay to ask for help, and that mental illness is just like any other illness, one that deserves attention and respect from others as you recover. And we will now view the statewide winning films in the Youth and Young Adult Mental Health Matters category.
I know it can be hard to be friends with people who have a mental illness, people like me. My life is affected by a disorder that makes it hard for me to socialize and communicate. It causes me to feel depressed, isolated, and misunderstood. It makes life complicated for me. Mental illness can feel like a monster to us, but that doesn't mean I am a monster, and it doesn't mean I should be treated like one. I'm a human being. I want to feel good, and I want to do good. I'm trying to be brave and strong, like a superhero. But I can't do all this on my own. I need support from you. Reach out and be a superhero to someone in need. Visit EachMindMatters.org to learn more about mental health challenges and what you can do.
This is Claire. Claire was a happy girl. Claire had good friends, good education, good hobbies, until shortly after Claire's 19th birthday, Claire developed symptoms of depression, and Claire didn't talk about depression. Depression didn't care if Claire was able to study. Depression didn't care if Claire ate well. Depression didn't care if Claire spent time with friends. Claire was no longer a happy girl. Until one day, Claire turned to her mental health. Mental health wanted Claire to talk. Mental health wanted Claire to have a support system. And mental health wanted Claire to be happy again. Good mental health is a key to combating mental health challenges like depression. Many college students like Claire suffer from mental health challenges each year. It's important for individuals like Claire to talk openly, seek help, and join the mental health movement. If you are interested in more information on mental health and/or the mental health movement, please visit these resources.
alright?
Nah, Mike. I think I'm just gonna go home.
Oh, alright, man. Well, I'll give you a call tonight.
Alright. Peace out, brother. Hey, Mike. What's up, man?
Nothing much, man. I was just calling to see if you're all right.
You know, dude, I'm not all right. I need to talk.
Third prize in the youth and young adult mental category in the Mental Health Matters goes to Phone Call, Riverside County, Mount San Diego College. Student names: Walter Polita, Sixto Romero, Jessica Casillas, and the advisor.
Hi there, everyone. How are you? All of you collectively. My speech isn't very well prepared, but basically, let me just get out what I need to say, I guess. Basically, with Phone Call, I want to say first thanks to my friend Sixto. He couldn't make it today because he had another engagement, but thank you on his behalf. Phone Call was cool because that's something that is very personal to me because I suffer from obsessive compulsive disorder, and it's something that makes my life really hard on a regular basis. Like, I'll have days where, like, sometimes I'm just doing great, you know, you're going on that upward spiral, but the sad thing about mental illness is that you always find yourself back in those, like, negative slumps. And every couple of months I'll find myself in one of those headspaces where it just feels like the end of the world. Like, I'm not gonna make it through this. Like, I am going to die here in my bed. And many times I've called a couple of my best friends and they have just been there for hours and just sit there and like, yo man, like, well, like they know what's up. Like, I've told them, you know, and they'll just sit there and like, yeah man, what's up? And just like, will avidly listen to everything that I have to say and everything where I'm just like, yo, I don't feel right. You know, all this, everything, like I'm stressed out, work, school. And they've been there to just listen through me like the whole way. And this is where all of us individually, if we know somebody with mental illness, it'll take a day out of the month. Just call them, hey man, what's going on? And that can be the difference. That can, like, if you feel just one person cares about you, that's enough motivation sometimes to get out of bed and work out and do whatever it is you need to do to make yourself a successful, productive human being. And so that's what I urge. If anybody here knows someone in that state, make a phone call.
Oh, I'm not done here. Second prize in the youth and young adult mental health category goes to... This is Claire, Yolo County, Active Minds at UC Davis. Mariam Pastor and advisor. Congratulations, guys. Come on up.
I have cried so many times already, and partly because it is difficult to watch all of these, but mostly because I see a lot of resilience in this room and on this screen. And this project has been a really meaningful one for us. We are officers of Active Minds, and it is part of a national nonprofit, but we have a chapter at our university, UC Davis. And like I said, it was a really meaningful project to make, so Mari will talk a little about it.
Yeah, so in our video, we really just want to show how prevalent mental health challenges are so that people know that they aren't alone when they're suffering through one, and also that there's so many resources out there for they themselves to find, and also for them to seek out for their friends or family members if they see them suffering. And also, we want to raise this awareness because it's so important to the mental health movement, and really the key to the movement and like helping others is the next generation, and that's really all of you guys out here, you high schoolers. Like, to see so many like talented young members so dedicated to this cause is so inspiring, and the work you guys are doing is really invaluable to so many, to me and so many others. So thank you guys, honestly.
And the first prize in the youth and young adult mental health category goes to Real Life Superhero. Del Norte County, Redwood Boys student Jebediah Hawkins and Mackenzie Williams. Congrats, guys.
Thank you very much. I'm so glad to be here. I hope my film will inspire people, not just in California, but the whole world, to be a superhero to someone in need, to someone who is suffering due to being isolated, misunderstood, and or bullied. We are all human beings, not monsters. In order to help myself, I want to help others. The contest gave me a new direction in life because it made me feel like a winner, and I've never won anything in my life like this. I'm gonna keep making films, not just for Hollywood one day, but to be inspiring to everyone. If you suffer from mental health challenges, listen to music, exercise your heart out, read books, take notes, get a doctor's appointment, talk to somebody you know, and reach out to somebody. But don't do drugs or attempt suicide or use violence on somebody else. Because I care about saving your lives. Any gender, any race, any species, any ability, any age can make a difference. I'd like to thank my mom, my dad, my brother, my grandparents, my aunts and uncles, even my cousins for inspiring me. God bless all of you.
Santiago, you got some competition for best speech of the day. I don't know. You next winners, you guys better bring it. So congratulations to all our statewide winners in the youth and young adult mental health matters category. And now we'll view the films in the statewide youth and young adult suicide prevention category.
My life has challenges, but high school was the worst challenge I went through. Kids were really cruel during those years. Teasing, mocking, saying insults, spreading lies, etc. It pretty much became unbearable. I didn't see an end to the pain I went through, which led me to cutting. When I did it, it released my pain, but only temporarily. I didn't know what else to do. When my teacher saw what I was going through, He helped me realize that I didn't need to cut to overcome my pain and suffering. Although I'm still struggling, I haven't cut in a few years. You may think you're alone in your struggles, but you're not. If you ever feel like you're not important or you feel like you want to end your pain, call the suicide prevention number. Call 1-800-273-TALK-8255. There are people who care. You're not alone.
If you or someone you love show signs of depression, contact the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline or visit www.suicidepreventionlifeline.com.
When I'm alone in my room, sometimes I feel like dying. No, I can't go on. I just need somebody to understand. Please give me a hand. Sometimes it's hard to hold on. I've been through so much pain, and it really does hurt me. Yet I just keep smiling on. I know everything will be okay. All this pain will go away. And I'm here to say, you don't get rainbows without any rain. There'll be sunshine tomorrow.
If you or somebody you know is contemplating suicide, please contact the National Suicide Prevention Hotline or a caring adult. Suicide can be prevented.
And third prize for the Youth and Young Adult Suicide Prevention category goes to Hope Melody, Riverside County, City of Indio, Teen Center, Edgar Ortiz, Andrew Martinez, Aureli Zarco, Juan Roberts, and Laura Humphrey.
We're just very honored to be here, and we hope that this video helps those in need.
I was like honored to be part of the video because like I had my friend, I had like he was gay and like he was bullied a lot up in school before. So like he took his own life and like it like hurt me because like I thought he could like talk to me and like I felt like he was somebody special to me too. So I just want like everybody to know that like you don't have to kill like commit suicide. You can always find help some way somehow. Thank you.
Beautiful.
And the second prize for the Youth and Young Adult Suicide Prevention category goes to Brighter Days, Los Angeles County, Pasadena City College, Natalie Adame, advisor Jennifer Garson.
By saying that I am so impressed and inspired by all of the videos that have been submitted. But I want to say that as an aspiring filmmaker, we ask ourselves two very important questions. And those two questions are, what kind of impact do I want to make? And what kind of influence do I want to be? And one of the things that I really want to do is inspire and unify people, which is what I think we're doing today. And I feel like everybody that's in this room is here because they support suicide prevention, mental health awareness, and in the later submissions, cultural diversity. So I just wanted to say thank you so much for having me here today. I feel so honored to be a part of such a good cause. Thank you.
And first prize in the Youth and Young Adult Suicide Prevention goes to, I Have Walked in Your Shoes, Solano County, BYBA Incorporated, Mason Connor, and Lynn Larson.
Well, hello there. It is truly an honor to be here amongst all of you people, both young and, well, I don't want to be rude and say old, but not, you're getting there, but experienced. We'll go with experienced. And again, with experience, you know, it comes from a lot of learning from your past. And with my video, I've learned that with, you know, the suicide, a lot of people kept trying to tell me it was a choice. I'm like, people choose to take their lives because they don't see an end. They don't see the road continuing, they just see it stopped. And that's why I thought my life was going, just nothing but a dead end. But thanks to one of my teachers who is here, Ms. Lynn Larson, she's helped me actually get here. Without her, I wouldn't be here. And yeah, thank you, Ms. Larson, for everything. You're amazing. And I also want to thank my high school drama acting teacher, Ed Hallback. He was one of the ones also who noticed that I started cutting. And he asked me what was my reason. And I told him I honestly felt alone, scared. I didn't want to continue, but he saw opportunity in me when I was on stage and when he saw my videos and when he saw my video up here, you know, he was very proud of me. And if he could be here right now, I know he'd be smiling. And again, I just want to thank all of you for showing support in this organization, because we really need this. There's a lot of people out there who are struggling. And I want every single one of you to know who are still struggling or have struggled or know anyone who's struggling, whether it's friends or family, you are definitely not alone. There are people you can talk to. Thank you.
One more round of applause for Ms. Meredith O'Connor. And Mason, thank you for an absolutely beautiful speech.
Unfortunately, I have some bad news for a little bit of the group here, and you gotta go back to school. Your teacher told me, and I'm telling you, I'm just the guy telling the guy and the gals. So don't everybody get up, but those students, and you know who you are, you ain't gotta go home, but you can't stay here. University. I know, somebody call the principal. Somebody tell them they're gonna be late, but the bus is gonna leave soon. I'm really sorry. But nobody leave besides them. Just head out to the lobby. You guys will take them. A round of applause for them for being here, ditching school to be here with us. And we're gonna give them just a second to exit. I apologize to break up the program, but we're running a little bit long. So with that, as they're exiting, it's nice to see all your beautiful faces out there. I feel like I've been talking to myself all night. And we will be right back with you. Yeah, and you guys can exit through both sides of the house. There's also exits on the left and the right towards you guys. All right, we're gonna resume. Thank you everyone for your flexibility. Bye guys, miss you, love you guys. All right, next to your submissions. All right, and with that, we're gonna continue with the program. So this year we introduced a new category that asked youth and young adults to explore suicide prevention and mental health through the lens of culture. Now there are many different definitions for culture, but here's the one that we use for purposes of providing direction to our filmmakers. Culture is the characteristics and perspectives of a particular group of people, defined by everything from language, ethnicity, nationality, religion, cuisine, social habits, sexual orientation, gender identity, a shared experience, music, arts, and more. And when it comes to mental health and suicide prevention, culture can influence how and if we talk about these topics, whether or not we seek help, and what kind of help and from whom. Now, this category was made possible in part from sponsorship from the Culture to Culture Foundation, a nonprofit community-based organization dedicated to promoting mental health and emotional wellness. Now, aside from the same requirements as either the mental health or suicide prevention categories, films submitted to this category of Through the Lens of Culture were required to have closed captioning to aid in wider dissemination of the films, as well as address specific cultural messages of hope and support. And we will now view the films for the Through the Lens of Culture Mental Health Matters category.
Hi, As a first-generation college student, mental health during your college years can be a difficult issue to address. Especially if you grew up speaking a language other than English at home. Sometimes, words for mental illness and treatment can get lost in translation.
Es difícil hablar de cómo me siento, pero quiero mejorar.
Alguien que yo amo tiene esquizofrenia y quiero hacer alguna cosa para ayudar a ella.
Even if you feel alone, we all speak the universal language of community. Reach out, get the support you need.
Yo tengo depresión.
我有忧郁症.
എനിക്കും വിഷാദമുണ്ട്.
Mental illness is something that transcends cultural boundaries, so no matter where you're from or what language you speak, mental illness can affect anyone. So go ahead and start a conversation.
Con la ayuda de mis compañeros, empecé una conversación.
我开始跟人家讲话的之后，我发现有很多人跟我一样.
എന്റെ ചികിത്സയുടെ ആദ്യത്തെ ഭാഗം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ എന്റെ വിഷാദത്തിനെ കുറിച്ച് ഒരു ചർച്ച തുടങ്ങുകയായിരുന്നു.
We started a conversation.
I was diagnosed with an anxiety disorder. Today, I had one of my most severe anxiety attacks. Through patience and time, I was able to communicate with peers and teachers. Together, we can break the silence on mental health.
Get the facts.
Talk openly.
Be supportive.
Help is available. Visit eachmindmatters.org or NAMI.org to join the movement and its impact on culture.
Now, unfortunately, Julio Cesar Ortiz, who is the senior health reporter for Univision 34 Los Angeles, had to cancel today due to a death of a close friend. So our thoughts and prayers go out to Julio. He was going to be joining me in presenting these awards. But instead, I got a new friend. I'd like to invite Michelle Enfield to the stage. She spoke with our youth this morning, and Michelle is a passionate advocate, a passionate speaker. She's Navajo. She speaks up about, she's Navajo, she's trans, and she's an advocate for many issues. She works currently as the LA, with LA County as the HIV commissioner. She's also an actor, and just an all-around amazing person, and she'd like to share a little bit of her story with you. So, Michelle, please join me.
Good afternoon. Yat Aisha Dineha, Michelle Enfield Yenisha, Tkachini in Schletz, and Ajini Abashish Chin Tohana Eda Chuche. Torichini that Shunala dihut adine inchle, dihut al nagle inchle. What I told you were my clans in Navajo. I am Dine from the Navajo Reservation, and I am also trans, and I deal with depression. She eya, she sits in a waza digis. What I said literally in Navajo was that my mind is crazy. This is part of the issues. When we're looking at language barriers, When we look at different communities, mental health affects them differently. People have different views of mental health. So I really appreciate the whole diversity of the films, the people that are present in the films. They're really representing all of our communities. So I not only just deal with depression, I deal with laughter, I deal with courage, resilience, and so many more things. And this is what is possible. I tried to commit suicide when I was young, and so today I treat every day like it doesn't even belong to me. And I have nothing to lose. I would have lost it many, many years ago. So today, thank you for stepping up, thank you for seizing this opportunity, thank you for being courageous, talented, young individuals, leaders of our future. And by the way, if any of you become famous directors, I am an actor. And I'm really grateful for Mental Health Awareness Month. Not only Mental Health Awareness Month, but other awareness months, such as Native Heritage Month, African American Heritage Month, Asian and Pacific Islander Heritage Month, even though those should be separated. This really is a culture. It is a chance for us to be acknowledgeable of other cultures. And there's one thing, we talk about intelligence, we talk about artistic creativity, which is something that each of you have. But one thing that we need to really focus on as well is our emotional intelligence. How do we know where we are in our situations when we are navigating our lives? And what about the person who is beside us, in front of us? How are they reacting to situations? Do you have the power within you to assist them, to put them on the right path? I think you do. And it is our job to continue to educate ourselves not only on mental health issues, but on many issues that affect our community. And when I say our community, I mean our human community. We have different races, we have different cultures, but we also represent one culture. So please remember to think of those that are not as visible or as represented in social media and widespread media. Media really teaches us a lot of things. And so today, I honor you for teaching us about mental health and where our youth stand. You, once again, are our future. And in the Native American way, we say that it takes 7 generations to make change, to create change. And I hope that it begins today. Ahiaha, thank you very much.
And Michelle is going to join me in recognizing our winners in the Through the Lens of Culture category. So, third prize for the Mental Health Matters Through the Lens of Culture goes to, hear me, Sacramento, Elk Grove High School, Curtis Wong, Morgana Parsons, Katrina Pacabar, and Mariana Ray. Advisor Jennifer Moore.
Thank everybody for being here, and thank you so much for giving us this opportunity to make a video that really talks about the issues of mental health in the deaf community and the deaf culture, because nobody really talks about it. And I personally connect with this video because, my mother, my mom is deaf. She lost her hearing when she was 3 years old. And I've grown up in the deaf community and watching her kind of struggle and feel isolated in a hearing world. So I just,
talk about this issue and bring awareness to it. And I'd like to thank Mr. Pick and Mrs. Moore and Patricia for bringing us out here and just giving us this opportunity to be here. And thank you so much. Wow. Okay, I was really hoping she wasn't gonna get emotional, and now I'm gonna get emotional. thank you so much to Mr. Pick, Ms. Moore, and Patricia. This is a wonderful opportunity for all of us. And as someone who is not an aspiring filmmaker, I think it's safe to say that even if you're not an aspiring filmmaker, by participating in this wonderful program, you're aspiring to change the world, and that's plenty.
All right, and the second prize for the Mental Health Matters Through the Lens of Culture category goes to Through Our Eyes, San Bernardino County, Ruben S. Ayala High School, Ashton Swing, Nelly Hajazi, Melanie Pack, and Nikhil Medikadu. Advisor Kevin Russell.
Thank you all for being here. We would like to thank Mr. Russell, our advisor, for encouraging us to participate in this program. And we want to thank Each Mind Matters for starting this very important discussion, because I was born in a rural part of South India, and in that community, issues like mental illness are not discussed at all. They're just kind of swept under the rug and people are ignored and so many people suffer. So to the extent where when I helped make this film, I didn't know the words for depression or anxiety in my language, so I had to call up my parents and ask them. So I want to thank this organization for making me aware of the responsibility that I have to the mentally ill and to just start this discussion and help people. So thank you.
Which means that the first prize for the Mental Health Matters Through the Lens of Culture category goes to The Language of Healing, San Francisco County, San Francisco State University, Alejandra Vaca and Amanda Data, advisor Vincent Lamb.
To receive this award today. And we would like to thank Each Mind Matters and the Directing Change Film Contest for providing us this wonderful opportunity to really voice our passion for mental health advocacy and awareness. And we'd also like to extend a thank you to our friends and family members for being supportive of us and our internship preceptor at San Francisco State University, Vincent Lamb, who really encouraged us to make this film despite not having any filmmaking experience.
Also, I'd like to just thank everybody here who participated in making all the films. It was very beautiful to see
people who are very passionate for the same causes and really trying to make a difference in people's lives. And we really hope this video resonates with first-generation students and, you know, youth of color, but for everybody, of course. And, you know, a lot of the struggles that we go through, and in certain cultures and communities, mental illness is not talked about, and sometimes there's not even words to describe how you feel. So we really hope that this makes an impact for those communities. And thank you. Y'all are beautiful.
Gracias.
Obrigada. Thank you.
And with that, we're going to view the winning films in the Through the Lens of Culture Suicide Prevention category.
私は不安な絶望的な気持ちを抱いています。小さな部屋に閉じ込められている気分です。誰か私を救い出してください。しかし私はこのことを人に打ち明けることはなかった。自分の気持ちを小さく折りたたみ、心の隅にしまい込もうとしていた。友達の前でもなるべく明るく振る舞い、病状を隠そうとしていた。 気づいてほしいと思っていながら、必死に隠そうとしていた自分だった。
その時私はその番号に電話をし、救い出してもらいました。 もし自殺を考えている人がいるのなら、一人で悩まず、ぜひ相談してくるように伝えてあげたいです。
Hanji sariya culture and vetch depression hindi ya
walang gana gumawa ng aktibidad
dificultad en concentrar
mukinyo shia puchichojo
for new piece of ana
sufrimientos y dolores
sad empty feeling
fetching
se sintiendo como si você não valesse nada
pensamientos en suicidio
walang pinipili ang depression.
I think we should all come together in culture so we could be together as one.
We are one.
After all,
you and I,
together we suffer.
Together, exist.
And forever, we will recreate each other.
If you think someone might be at risk for suicide, you need to seek help from a trusted adult immediately. Or call 911 or the Central Valley Suicide Prevention Hotline at
1-888-506-5991. Aiqui, hello. I'm a survivor of suicide. I'm here to tell you that there's a state of emergency on Indian country and reservations nationwide. We as a people have faced genocide through plague and disease, politics and religion, and now by our own hands, we are taking our own lives. Suicide doesn't heal or take the pain away. It only harms yourself and most of all the ones you love. Culture, language, family, ceremony, and the healing of our lands are the way we heal and restore ourselves and our people. If you, family, or friends is feeling suicidal, please reach out. For more help or information, you can call National Suicide Prevention Lifeline or look up suicidpreventionlifeline.org.
Esta es la historia de mi amigo Tyler. Durante nuestro primer año de la escuela secundaria, comenzó a alejarse de nuestro grupo de amigos. Después de esto, se volvió al alcohol y las drogas. Traté de mostrar mi preocupación, pero no se había dado cuenta de que solo estaba tratando de ayudar.
Bueno, he estado pensando en esto por un tiempo ahora. No puedo seguir así, viviendo de esta manera, a menos que algo en mi vida cambie. Así que al fin voy a hacerlo. Voy a buscar ayuda. Así que ha sido 2 meses desde que tenía pensamientos suicidas y estoy muy agradecido por Andrea, que ayudó a salvar mi vida.
And we actually have a tie for third place, which is wonderful because I love both of these films. But the first of the third place awards that we will present goes to My Friend Tyler, Placer County, Whitney High School, Matt Daisy, Noah Lopez Cohen, advisor Benjamin Barnard.
Okay, so suicide is probably something that's touched pretty much everyone in this room, including myself. So I'd just like to thank Directing Change for giving us an outlet to really spread awareness for this disease and the issue that's really affecting our generation and pretty much everyone around the world. Thanks.
Thank you. So, like Matt already said, we just want to make it clear that suicide and mental illness, it affects more than one culture. So we just wanted to thank everybody at Directing Change, our actors and our families for making this possible. And what's really important is it starts with you. And I think everybody in this room is doing their part. So I thank you guys for that. And you guys are actually making a big impact on this world. Thank you.
And the other third prize for suicide prevention in the Through the Lens of Culture category goes to Suicide on Indian Country, Humboldt County Transitions Age Youth Collaboration, Tristan Severn, and Leah Madrigal.
I'm really honored actually to have won this award. I'd like to thank Jamie Lee Evans, an amazing supporter for us, taking us up here. I'd like to thank my organization, Humboldt County Transition Age Youth Collaboration. And mainly, I'd like to thank all of you, really, because y'all are just actually making the biggest strides to make a difference in every community out there. And it's amazing to see everyone come together and make a difference, whether it's small or big. I mean, I wish we could have gave awards out to everyone, to be honest, you know what I mean? But it's a beautiful thing. Like Michelle said, we're all under the same human race, and it's all about making a better place for the next 7 generations. And I feel like the steps we are making today are gonna end it soon, if not maybe tomorrow. If we keep this act up, this work, and all this, it's just, we're gonna see a lot of change, and I'd like to thank every one of you. I know I'm up here getting my vaccinations, but I kinda wanna put the spotlight on all y'all. So thank you so much.
So second prize for suicide prevention in the Through the Lens of Culture category goes to Depression Has No Culture, Fresno County, Clovis East High School, Megan Eckenman, Ariana Spear, Caitlin Luster, Malia Willison, advisor Derek Davis.
All right, so for like the last week, we've been trying to figure out what we're going to say up here, and we're still in the process of figuring that out, so bear with us. Thanks. So the four of us as peer counselors at our high school take great pride in what we do. We're all about raising awareness and being there for people. sorry, I'm a little shaky, a little nervous. And we're just so excited and honored to be here and receive this award. And we're absolutely grateful for this amazing program and the opportunity to do our part and raise awareness and help end mental health stigma.
Okay. Like Megan said, this was a very nice opportunity for us to come out and really support what our school's all about. I just wanted to thank a few people before we leave off stage, which would be Brian Bishop. He helped us coordinate a camera. We're girls, so we don't really know cameras, so thank you, Brian. We would also like to thank our peer counseling advisor, Mr. Davis. He really pushed us and encouraged us to make our video, and our peer counseling class for supporting and encouraging us to really push ourselves to find all these people that spoke different languages at our school, and I'd just like to thank this program. Thank you.
Which means that the first prize for the suicide prevention in the Through the Lens of Culture category goes to My Hidden Feelings, Orange County Canyon High School, Nicole McCready, and Kana Akapuji, advisor Alex Graham.
Thank you to Directing Change for the opportunity to create a film addressing such an important issue. And also thank you to my parents for all the support and to our advisor, Mr. Graham.
I'd also like to thank Directing Change for this award. It's such an honor. And I would like to thank our friends and family for their support, as well as our advisor, Mr. Graham.
Yeah.
So this is actually our second year participating in the Directing Change Film Contest, and we've been wanting to make a foreign film in Japanese together. So when we saw that there was a new category this year called Through the Lens of Culture, we knew that we wanted to submit a PSA in this category. I'm fluent in Japanese, and I'm very familiar with their culture since my mother is from there, and I've been there numerous times, so it was really cool that I was able to utilize this in this film.
So speaking of that, we both actually took a trip to Japan recently, and this was my very first time there. So it was really interesting to get to learn about their cultural differences. And after doing some research when working on this project, we really learned that the way that mental health is perceived throughout the world really isn't that different. So we just want everyone, we hope that this film can show everyone that suicide is preventable if others aren't afraid to talk about it and discuss it. Thank you.
Thank you.
And just one more big round of applause for Michelle Enfield for being here with us.
Hashtag follow the love. Hashtag get in where you fit in. Hashtag handle your scandal. And hashtag get over yourself. Thank you.
Congratulations to all of our filmmakers. And if you could please join me in one huge round of applause for all of the filmmakers here today. A closing note to those filmmakers. I want to thank you on behalf of all of us here for your courage and your strength. Your presence here today and your support of mental health and suicide prevention will have a lasting impact. You probably heard of someone named Steve Jobs. He once said, "You cannot connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect the dots looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in the future. You have to trust in something. Your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn path. And it's likely that many of you will never see the ripple effects that your films have in others' lives. These films will be shared with people throughout California and beyond. Your words, your voice may very well be the changing moment in someone's life. But I promise you that one day you'll look back to this moment, to this experience and these memories of participating in directing change, and then you will be able to connect the dots. Now, you've heard me speak a lot tonight about the power of one, and you've heard some absolutely beautiful stories from our young filmmakers about that. You've listened to me call you to action in our communities and in your lives to stand and join the movement for mental health. We've been inspired today by these films, these speakers, these filmmakers, and it is vital that we take this energy and action back into the world. But you may be wondering, what difference can I make? What can one do? What can I do? Again, the power of one. So what difference can one person make? One person can pick up the phone for someone in need. One person can listen when it feels like the world simply can't hear you. One can be all the difference in the world. In the wise words of one of the boat captains from the massive river rescue that occurred on September 11, 2001, there is a hero in each of us. You just gotta look in there. It'll come out. If you are a filmmaker, actor, director, be the hero to bring these messages of hope and recovery to the screen. If you're a journalist, I challenge you to bring this message to our communities with the power of your voice. For the youth in the room, don't ever let anyone keep you from standing up for what is right and what is just. For all of you here, for our friends and our family members, bring this message back to their lives, back to your lives, and back to your homes. Be the one, be the hero, simply by saying, "I'm here. I see you." I leave you today with this Pueblo prayer. Hold on to what is good, even if it is a handful of earth. Hold on to what you believe, even if it is a tree that stands by itself. Hold on to what you must do, even if it is a long way from here. Hold on to your life, even if it is easier to let go. Hold on to my hand, even if someday I'll be gone from you. I want to thank you for joining us this afternoon to give recognition to these filmmakers. Thank you all for helping to direct change. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.